You have a choice to make. Will you have faith to believe that God can work it out? Or will you believe that your difficulties will ultimately leave you worse off? If I can pause here and give you my topic on tonight, somebody grab your neighbor by the hand and tell a neighbor, stop all that trick. And let the word do the work. Tell somebody else, stop all that tripping. And let the word be the word. Is he promised? He promised. He promised, my God. If you choose to believe in God rather than your feelings, then God will act upon his promise. There are some reasons why you should believe the word of God is called the sword of the Holy Spirit. In Ephesians 6 and 11, we are told to put on the whole armor of God that we may be able to stand against the strategies of the devil. The word of God is the weapon the Holy Spirit uses on our behalf in this warfare. In fact, everything God does is governed by his word. Hebrews the 4th chapter verse 12 declares that it is living and powerful. Isaiah the 55th chapter verse 11 says it always produces the results that God declares. My God, the Bible declares that my word shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish what I have sent it out to do. I wish I had a witness that I had been preached tonight. We live by it in Matthew 4 and 4. When being tempted by the devil, Jesus stated that man should not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. This shows how essential it is for us to give God's word our priority in our lives. The word of God only works effectively if we believe. The word of God, which is also effectively, works in who you believe. Point number two, as I move swiftly, meditate on it. Somebody say meditate on it. Another important step is to meditate on God's word. In other words, we must study the Bible and think about the scriptures. Even to the point where we can repeat them back to ourselves. Sometimes in this body of Christ, we tend to read the Bible, yes, but we don't understand it. We seem to just skim through the pages, and I'm a witness because I do it too. Sometimes I just want to hold my Bible and read it, but sometimes when you read it, you might not get the full understanding of what the word is saying. Yes, sometimes you read, oh, God is not a man that he shall lie, nor the son of man that he shall repent. But you have to understand, what does that actually say?
Right. Come on.
See, us as black folk, can I keep it real? We get lazy and we find time to do everything else but study the word of God. We pick up the Bible in Kings and time, next thing you know, we get sleepy, or we pick up the word and we get hungry, or things happen to distract us from doing what the Lord has called us to do. But I wish I had about five people that understood, if I could just put everything aside and pick up the word, I would be better off. I'm moving. This is an important step, to meditate on the word. People are focused on reading many verses in chapter, but they're not committed to reading the word of God on a day-to-day basis. And then wonder why, when you go through hell in your life, you won't have nothing to fight with. They wonder why when the trials come from all sides and oppositions, it seems like every time you do one thing, another thing comes, and every time you do good, evil seems to just take you over. But we have to get in the word so we have something in us.
Yes.
See, my dad always tells me, he said, it got to be in you. He said, once you get the word in you, nobody can take it out of you. Because once you get the word in you, I don't care if they have a two-edged sword that goes into your skin, they cannot pull the word out of you. Because what's in you, we do it all the time. We may read a lot. We may feel accomplished. We may feel like we accomplished a lot. We read from Genesis to Numbers, and we feel like we accomplished a lot, but what have you learned from Genesis to Numbers? What have you really took in? What have you really laid upon yourself? What have you thought about while reading this passage of Scripture? What convicted you while reading these verses? What convicted you while reading these chapters? I'm moving on. You need to set your mind on God. And set your mind on the things of God. Because when we get distracted with everything else, and then we call God when we need him the most. Because I realize that a lot of times in the church world, we only call on Jesus when we're going through.
Right. That's
the truth. We only call on Jesus when our son just got arrested, and now he's doing about 36 to life, and things just look like it ain't getting better. When my daughter's on crack and nobody knows what to do, when mommy went out and sleeping with the neighbor, when daddy's going out messing with every hoot and hop, when things are going wrong in your life, we find time to call on the peacemaker. I told you I didn't come to play tonight. We tend to go to God when we need him, but when God says, I need your praise, I need your worship, we be like, oh God, well, that's a little too much right now. I'm kind of busy right now. But when you want something from God, you want him to do it when you want him. It becomes real to us, and it influences us the way we think. And ultimately, it influences the way we live. In this Bible, in this word of God that we so-called live by, yeah, so-called live by. Because, yeah, we can quote scriptures for days.
Uh-huh. Well,
but we can't live it. I can tell you that the wages of sin is death. Uh-huh. But what are you doing after service? I'm sorry, Apostle. I did not come to play with y'all. But we can do all these things and tell people all these things. But what are we doing in ourselves? What kind of skeletons do we got in our closet? We got the nerve to pull out what you're doing and wonder why the people don't come to church. If we get our life right and walk according to what the Lord has called us to do, then maybe. Maybe our churches will get more full than it is.
Come on.
Maybe, if we decide to get our head out of our rear ends and thinking we're better than everybody and thinking the only goal in life is to be better than you. No, iron sharpens iron. We got to go to a place. At the end of the day, we all trying to make it in. So why don't I help you get to where you're supposed to be? Apostle, they don't like this type of message. But I need you to understand that the word of God is there for a reason.
It's a message.
We messy. See, I'm glad you done tapped in already. See, the people of God has dug themselves into the dirt. We have done so many things, but when we get to a place where God can use us, we feel like we the most important thing. We feel that we so great. We feel